Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today we're going to talk about Java and the web and what can we do to run Java code in the browser on the web. Before we had something called Java scriptlets or something like that, and these were small packages that you downloaded to your browser. You had to have an extension, you had to have Java installed, and then you can run these applets, Java applets. That was a way to actually run Java code in your browser. And they were deemed very unsecure and not really a good way to go, so many people have turned off Java in the browser and don't use that anymore. There are some companies that have built actual products using applets. They need this technology, but many people, at least in the consumer route or in the private sector, they have removed all of this. So what can we do today if we want to write Java code and we want it to run on the web? So I have three little examples here, three different projects, and I want to show them off. First off, we have something that's called TVM, and this is something very strange. You take Java code and compile it into JavaScript code that you can run in your browser. So the Java code looks something like this. You create a document, you create some HTML element, in this case it's a div, and then you add some text node to that, and in this case we have some generated element over here, and then you add this to your body. And this is something that I created using archetype in Maven. So this comes with TVM, so this is an example from their page. And if you package this with Maven, you will get both a var file that you can run in your application server of choice, or you can open it up in the web browser. Just open up that directory and go to the index.html in that page. And if we do that, we will get something like this. TVM generated element. Woo! Not very exciting, but we can see here that we actually get something out. And it wasn't this big. I have added some styling to the templates just so you can see the text easily. And if we go back here, we have the next project that builds upon TVM, where they have added some extra flavor, and this project is called Flavor. And here we see that we have some Java class, we have a template that we bind to here, this client template. We can look at that little bit. Here we have a template where we have some div in the beginning here. We have please enter your name as a label. We have an input text here where the HTML value is username and the HTML change, what should be changed, is the username. And then we have this little hello down here, an HTML text, and the username should be written there as well. So this is some output field where we can output username, and up here we have some input for inputting username. And if we go back to the client Java here, we can see that we have some string here, username. In our main program, we create a client and bind application content to that client. And then we have here the username, get username, and set username. And this class is the client. So we create one of these, which is of the type of application template, and then it's bound to this template. So it seems a little bit weird and interconnected in some way, but I think you can use this and go forth and actually broaden it a lot to make a very interesting application if you like. So what does this little example actually give us? Well, if we go back to the web browser here, we can see that we get an input field where I can type in my name and I actually get hello Daniel. So this is a very nice way to create something interactive where you can enter things and then get a change back into your web browser. But this is still a way of compiling your Java code into JavaScript. So you take something that you have in Java and then create something that you can run in JavaScript. And it's a lot of JavaScript and it's a lot of boilerplates. It's a runtime that runs this. So in a way, you are actually trying to create the same environment on the web. So if you are not comfortable with writing JavaScript code and want to run some Java code instead and generate all the JavaScript code, then this might be a good way to go. But I think I've found a really fun project that could take it a little bit further. And if you go into my little IDE here, you see that I have an HTML template up here, but we can start to look in the POM file. It's nothing here. I have actually added the two jar files that are needed. This is JWebAssembly API and JWebAssembly compiler, and both these I needed to add to actually build this. And I have actually tried to import them here, but as you see, 1.0 is not available because this project, it's a year old. It's a labor of love for one developer, so it's not that fully fledged yet. It's up on Maven MVM repositories, but I can't actually download it, so I'm not really sure what the problem is there. But this is a really fun little project. He have implemented more than 3/4 of the language, the WebAssembly language. But when it comes to the Java language, you can only support native types. So you can have ints, floats, doubles, and longs and as your variables in and out. But you can import code and export code. So if you look at my little code example here, you see that I have my add example from before. I will export this add function where I add A with B and then add 18 to that. And we can change this value so it's actually 4. So we add 4 instead. And in my index HTML here, the only thing I do is I have a result box up here. I get this result box by get element by ID. I have something that does something when you import JavaScript function into your Java code. And in this case, we just print out the arguments that actually are sent to the Java code. But we are not using JavaScript imports at the moment. And then we fetch our WASM file. So this is a WebAssembly. We take that array buffer and port it through all the bytes. So this WebAssembly initiate, and this in turn will take these bytes and initiate them with this import object function up here. And then we get a result. And in this result, we have an instance with exports and our add function. And this add function, I just can run down here. So 1 + 3, where I will put into inner HTML. But how can I use this little tooling to compile this code here into WebAssembly? And then you use this little short code here where I have my WASM file. I have this Java library or Java class JWebAssembly. And then I take the class I want to compile, so in this case code, and I just use this little funky resolve function here. It's quite long, so we can split it up a bit. And this is an example that actually was given in an issue from the developer, because it's a very new project. So he just wanted to show that you can use this, but it's still a little bit early perhaps. So here we take the class resource, and we get the URL from that by looking for the class name and replace the dots with the slashes. So that's pretty much going from a package name to a directory name, and we look for that class in there, and then we will get a URL where this class that we want to compile actually resides in the resource directory. And we add that file to our JWebAssembly, and then we compile that to a binary JWASM file. You can actually compile to text if you want to see how this actually looks as a WASM text. So that's the WASM source code that you then create a binary from. So WASM has a source code language that you can actually compile with this as well. So you can take Java code to WASM source code if you like. And if we run this little example here, it goes pretty fast, and then it will compile and run that, and we will have this test WASM file here. And we open the other little editor here, and we can open this up, and you see this is the WASM file. It's not a large WASM file, but if we go over to our web browser, open that up and reload it, it actually shows 8, and that's 1 + 3 + 4. So it actually ran our newly compiled WASM file. So what I think is very exciting about this is we found a way to actually run WASM files natively with a lot less code. And I also found this really nice Java library, which is still developing, so there will be more supported things in the future, where you can actually take some Java code and do some calculations or do something fun with it, and actually return the result to your web page. It's still something you just play around with, but I still think it's a really fun thing that it actually are people that are working on creating compilers for Java, so you can use them on in a WASM file. I hope that you found this as exciting as I thought it was. I hope that you found this video interesting. I hope that you like this video. Then give it a like. Share it with your friends and colleagues. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.